be piled around that couch over there in the corner.
Well, listen, we're all up here.
It's such a nice thing, otherwise we'd be doing it over on that couch with a lot of water lying out on that couch. And in your pen, right?
All of you here, though, I just wanted to say thank you for the way you worked together. I was fearful that something was gonna come down here, I was going to have to veto it. I think you all performed very handsomely.
We have about 60 seconds. Momentary delay, sorry.
Is this a bit of a fool?
They're coming in.
When you were behind us, you give us the leverage, but not have a fail, that would be important.
We came up on a working formula that we knew had been.
I'm in now, so I can't tell the story.
Oh, you can do it.
All right.
All right, there you go.
Takes a while between do it before it ends.
That's funny.
Signed, and since I've got four pens left over, I'll get four pens.
Thank you, President.
Whoops.
Thank you very much, Mr. President.
Thank you, sir.
Senate warrants are none. If y'all get together there,
you could come join us.
Jesse here, Frank.
He's the only one I asked John Warner to get. He didn't.
We got your memo.
We'll do that.
Thank you.
I think you started us on an auspicious occasion.
Congratulations. Good luck to you in the next couple of days. You did a wonderful job. We're behind you. I meant that, what I said.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you all. We're going to do all we can help with this.
Anybody need a ride? Everybody got cars? Yeah, thank you. Everybody got cars? I'll get home.
Been trying to get started.
Service. was the result of deliberations by committee members to be located, but they represented the professions that were essential to the work of that library. They were historians, they were librarians, they were archivists. Don Wilson came with the confidence of those people, and in his tenure in this department,
I have a report that there are some people, the only form I regret to say, who have not always understood the importance of having presidential libraries scattered around the country, bringing the sense of the presidency of the states. They have regarded them somewhat as the American version of the pyramids. But in that case, the public interest is abstract and the public is only invited as spectators from time to time. But I'm pleased to say that Don Wilson and his colleagues in the presidential libraries about 5 years ago began a program in allowing these modern descendants of the American town meetings to use the presidential libraries as a way to conclude their national conferences and talk to policymakers. Don Wilson started the first of those, and even this year, although the program has moved to other locations, it continues locally. The archives, truly public institutions. So in this year, when we have great reason, because of the bicentennial of the Constitution, to reflect on our character, we have every reason to welcome this appointment.
Don and Patsy Wilson, distinguished guests. 3 years ago, on November the 8th, 1984, a very special ceremony occurred in this great rotunda. It was a joyous celebration, marking the enactment of the National Archives Independence Bill. The legislation marked the culmination of a dream of more than two decades to make the National Archives an independent agency of the United States. Many thought it impossible. It was not a coincidence that our soloist for that day chose to sing Davis as one of the great cultural institutions of the United States. This first appointment under the new law is of greatest significance because it will, in all...
The final moment that I'd like you to join me in considering requires no imagination. It is now oppressive. Like the men of 1787, like Lincoln and Abraham.
I, Don Wilson, do solemnly swear that I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States. I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States against all enemies, foreign and domestic, against all enemies of foreign and domestic. That I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same. That I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same. That I take this obligation freely. That I take this obligation freely without any mental reservation or purpose of evasion. Without any mental reservation or purpose of evasion. That I will well and faithfully discharge. That I will well and faithfully discharge the duties of the office on which I am about to enter. The duties of the office about which I am about to enter. So help me God. So help me God.